to make space for new priorities. Because as we walk, the first thoughts are practically measured. At what time should we set the alarm? At breakfast, lunch, dinner, or where to sleep? But in the midst of this practical thought is the world. No one can even clearly explain the emotional experiences, the suffering in the feet and legs, the joy of meeting and the tragic and agonizing farewell as a worker. All these aspects, together with the landscape, nature, history and tradition of every single place, mean that walking makes us see the world in a different light. One walk for no particular reason, says Le Breton, but for pleasure of testing the passing of time, to allow oneself a deviation in order to find oneself again at the end of the route. To discover unknown places and faces, to increase the bodily awareness of a world full of sense of sensation. And this is even more true. As we walk, all our senses are alerted, and all is amplified to the nth power. It's little like seeing a film in 3D, but you are there, and you are also enjoying the scenery. You find yourself face to face with the power of nature. You find yourself in front of a sunrise that you never thought you would see. And that sunset that purifies your soul. You stand still to contemplate, and you find yourself smiling, thinking how much the world can still surprise you. The art of walking is extremely primitive and ancestral. First, we were nomadic people, and then we create routes in order to go from a place to another. Some of us have had the privilege of following these routes on foot and finding traces of our history. Thinking about walking of Roman basalt, barefoot, I can assure you, it's a wild emotion. You can perceive the passage of 1,000 people from past centuries. Working on the Francigena more than once has been a continual discovery. I saw the sequences lined up like a soldier, opening the street to an extraordinary palace. And then I walked up the stairs of elegant palaces, dreaming that I was really invited to a festival. I was overwhelmed by the emotion near an old decrepit church. I explored mystical places, enveloped in history and legend. There is no greater pleasure than I walking on a vestige of history, whether they are religious, spiritual, or mystical. Arriving in Rome has not only a religion value. Seeing the dome from the height makes you conscious that you are arrived. Your eyes filled with tears. Finally, you are in front of what you believe was your final destination, but you realize that was only the beginning. Piazza San Pietro in front of you, with its shape, seems to welcome you like a mother who holds a child to herself. She cradles you and holds you secure in her hands, and in that moment you breathe deeply and relax yourself into this embrace. The ability to listen to the world above means that everyone has different reactions to certain signs or coincidences. Sometimes this sight can be discovered in the face of people that you meet, their words or their silence. Some people enter your life, even just for a day. Others pass like a parabola, but become part of you for the rest of the life. Because these people have given you a piece of the puzzle that you love. And now it remains for you only to know where to be. You reach the goal, but the journey is still long. Walking, for those who try it, is a gesture of extreme freedom, a dialogue with oneself, with nature and past. Walking teaches us how life can be simple if you can contain it in a rucksack.